Kubernetes is a platform for managing your containers. Machine learning workflows can often get really messy, especially in production. So it was only a matter of time before somebody put the two together. How do we do machine learning on Kubernetes without too much extra work? Stay tuned to find out. Welcome to AI Adventures, where we explore the art, science, and tools of machine learning. My name is Yufeng Guo, and on this episode, we're going to check out Kubeflow, an open source project to help make running machine learning training and prediction on Kubernetes clusters easier. The Kubeflow project is dedicated to making deployments of machine learning workflows on Kubernetes simple, portable, and scalable. More specifically, it wants to allow you to easily deploy your code to all sorts of environments, from, say, your laptop to a desktop with two GPUs, or, say, a training Kubernetes cluster versus a production cluster. And of course, this wouldn't be Kubernetes if it didn't allow you to scale everything with demand. Kubeflow began life as a way to open source TensorFlow Extended, or TFX, which was how TensorFlow is run internally at Google. While it was originally just a simpler way to run TensorFlow jobs on Kubernetes, it has since expanded to become a multi-architecture, multi-cloud framework for running entire machine learning pipelines with many contributors all across the ecosystem. This might be a good time for a little confession. I don't know a whole lot about Kubernetes. Having spent the past several years focused on TensorFlow and data science and machine learning, my Kubernetes skills are, well, they're not exactly top-notch. So I'm really hoping that Kubeflow can allow me to deploy TensorFlow and other machine workloads onto Kubernetes successfully, because I do hear Kubernetes is pretty great. So let's see what it looks like to use Kubeflow, shall we? Kubeflow aims to be able to run anywhere Kubernetes can. This means everything from your laptop to bare metal servers, all the way to the public cloud. For now, let's check out how this works on Google Kubernetes Engine, or GKE. Installing Kubeflow to GKE is actually shockingly simple, since there's a click-to-deploy user interface. All I had to do was enter the project ID of my cloud project, give my deployment a name, and choose a zone to put it in. Then all the necessary resources were provisioned automatically. Now that is my kind of deployment. So with Kubeflow installed and the UI accessible, you're ready to dive into the world of Kubeflow. You can train models, visualize them with TensorBoard, serve models, build pipelines, and log into JupyterHub to manage all these things. Most of the time, we get to use the very same training code that we would be running locally anyway, and just add some configuration files for the Kubeflow specific parts. And then you can run them in Kubeflow with no code changes. I can perform training on my Kubernetes cluster using Kubeflow and have the exported model either stay on disk in the Kubernetes cluster or send it off to a Google Cloud Storage bucket, allowing me to easily share or deploy the trained model to systems outside of the cluster. All right, that's enough of me talking. If you're interested in running machine learning pipelines on Kubernetes, then it's time for you to get started on Kubeflow. I've linked to a number of code labs and resources in the description down below to help you get started. Thanks for watching this episode of Cloud AI Adventures. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to get all the latest updates right when they come out. For now, head down to the description below for more information about how to get Kubeflow up and running on your Kubernetes cluster.